Yes. So this is my third video on NCERT Class 12 Chapter 3 Matrices. So in the first video, I have given a brief introduction to matrices, right? So whenever if someone asks what is meant by matrices, you should not simply say that it is a rectangular arrangement of numbers, etc., etc. What you have to say is it is some transformations, right? So if you are given 2x2 matrix, you should say it is a transformation in a 2-dimensional plane. If it is a 3x3 matrix, it is a transformation in a 3-dimensional plane, right? So, if you haven't watched the first video, you please watch that video because first video is very, very important, right? Then only you know why we are studying matrices, and the following concept will be very easy for you if you have understood the first video, right? And the second video, I have given a basic introduction to exercise 3.1, right? So, if you have learned 3 concepts, then you can answer all the sums in exercise 3.1. So first is the definition of a matrix and then an order of a m cross n matrix, right? So what will be the order of a matrix? And we have seen types of matrices and equality of matrices. So these are the only 3 concepts that are in exercise 3.1, right? So first one is definition of matrices and types of matrices and equality of matrices. So in the last video I have explained all 3 concepts and then we have solved all example problems, right? So in this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to finish all exercise problems in exercise 3.1, right? So again, you go through the video 2, right? That is the previous video. In the description, I have provided a link for video 1, video 2, 1, video this video 3, right? So I will give you the link for video 1 and video 2. That is lecture 1 and lecture 2, right? So in this video, what we're going to see is we are going to solve all exercise problems in exercise 3.1. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, so please subscribe and share with your friends, right? Yeah. So we'll get on to the video. So there are 10 problems in this exercise. And there are 10 problems. And after finishing this 10 problem, we will go on to the next video that is based on operation on matrices. So we'll get on to the video. So this is lecture 1 introduction. If you want notes for it, I can upload this PDF later. And lecture 2 is intro to exercise 3.1, right? So this is the second video and this is third video. That is what I am going to solve all exercise problems. And in the next video, I am going to give an introduction to exercise 3.2. So in this video, we will solve the exercise problems, right? Yeah, so there are 10 problems. So in this video, we will finish off all the 10 problems. So we'll get on to the video. The first question is, in the matrix A is equal to 2, 5, 19, minus 7, 3, 35, minus 2, 5 by 2, 12, root 3, 1, minus 5, 17, write the order of a matrix, the number of elements and write the elements of A13, A21, A33, A24 and A23, right? So these are very elementary problems. So I'll finish off this very quickly. So first I ask this, what is the order of a matrix, right? So we know the order of a matrix is the order of the matrix should be in the format m by n, where m denotes the number of rows and n denotes the number of columns, right? So here you can see there are 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 rows. And how many columns here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So first you have to write row and then you have to write the column, right? So order of matrix is equal to 3 cross 4, right? 3 cross 4. Because it has 3 rows and 4 columns. And second is write the number of elements. So we know number of elements in a m by n matrix is what? Number of elements in m by n matrix is equal to m into n, right? So therefore, number of elements in a 3 cross 4 matrix, in a 3 cross 4 matrix will be equal to 3 into 4, which is equal to 12. So there are 12 elements here. And third one is, they have asked us to find the A13 and A21, A23 and A24 and A23, right? So A13 means what? First row, the first number denotes the row and second number denotes the column, right? Rows, column, A, I, J, right? I denotes rows, J denotes the column. So first row, third column. So first row, third column. What is the answer? It will be equal to 19. Second row, first column. So second row, first column. So it is 35. Third row, third column. So this is third row. Third column is minus 5. Second row, fourth column. So this is second row. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth column. So therefore it is 12. Second row, third column. So second row, third column. 1, 2, 3. So it is equal to 5 by 2. Right? That's it. So we'll move on to the second question now. So a matrix has 24 elements. What are the possible orders it can have? Right? So we have solved similar problems in example sum. That is, in that question, we have 8. Right? So here, the order of a matrix is m cross n. A matrix has 24 elements, right? So, number of elements, it is given that number of elements is equal to 24. That means, we need to find a m cross n matrix. So, we know that order of a matrix is m cross n and number of elements will be equal to m into n. So, it is given that the number of elements is 24. So, we need to find two numbers such that if you multiply the two numbers, you should get 24 as answer. So, what are the possibilities that there are? So, first we can take 1 into 24, right? 1 into 24. And if I take 2 here, I'll have, so I'm just going from 1, 2, 3, etc., right? So, 1 into 24, 2 into 12, right? 2 into 12 is also 24. 3 into 8 is 24, right? 3 into 8 is 24. And 4 into 6 is 24. And 5 tables cannot be, we cannot obtain 24 from 5 tables. So that's it, right? And 6 cannot be possible. Ah, yes. So this is 6 into 4. 7 not possible, right? 8 is possible. 9 not possible. 10 not possible. 11 not possible. 12 is possible, right? 12 into 2. And 13 is not possible. And again, 24 is the last. So, these are all the possible combination we can have, right? So, how many of them are here? What are the possible orders it can have? So, the possible orders are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, there are 8 possible orders it can have. That means, a matrix can contain one row and 24 columns. That is, it can be in the format like 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 24 elements. So, you can see number of elements is 24. Or, it can have 2 rows, 12 columns. So, 2 rows and 12 columns. So, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Right? So, you can have like this. Right? 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Yeah, it can have like this, right? So, 12 elements in the first row, 12 elements in the second row. Then we will have overall 24 elements. Or we can have 3 rows, 8 columns. So, 3 rows. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, it can be in this format also. Or it can have 4 rows and 6 columns. So, these are all the possible combination that a matrix can if it has 24 elements. What are the possible orders it can have? What if it has 13 elements? So, you can see 13 is a prime number, right? So, 13 is a prime number. So, for prime numbers, the only factors are 1 into 13 and 13 into 1, right? These are the only two factors. So, if it has the number of elements is prime number, either it can be 1 into 13 or 13 into 1. That means 1 row 13 columns or 13 row 1 column. That means 1 row 13 columns up to 13, or it can have 13 rows 1 column. Right? So, these are the only two possible combinations. That's it. So, we'll move on to the third problem now. If a matrix has 18 elements, what are the possible orders it can have? So, our m into n is given as 18 elements. So we need to find two numbers whose multiplication will give you a 18. So first we'll start with 1. So 1 into 18. If you start with 2, 2 into 9, right? Yeah. 3 into 6. 4 is not possible, right? Because we cannot multiply a number with 4 to get a number 18. 5 not possible. 6 is possible, right? So 6 into 3. 7 is not possible, right? That means 7 into something will have to give you 18. This is not possible, right? Yeah. So 8 is not possible again. So 9 is possible. 9 into 2. And 10 is not possible, right? 11 is not possible. 12 is not possible. 12 is not possible because 12 into something will have to give you 18, right? So 12 into 1 is 12, into 2 is 24. 18 is not possible. So again 13, 14 is not possible. So 18 into 1. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 possible orders. So a matrix can be a 1 cross 18 matrix. That means 1 row 18 columns, or it can have 2 rows 9 columns, or it can have 3 rows 6 columns, etc. So 6 possible order. What if it has 5 elements? So again you can see our number of elements is mn, right? So it is 5, again which is equal to prime. So we need to find two numbers which will if you want to multiply two numbers, you have to get the number as 5. So only possible combinations are 1 into 5 and 5 into 1. So there are only two possible orders if the number of elements is equal to 5, and there are 6 possible orders if the number of elements is equal to 18, right? Yes. So what I will do is I will give you a nice shortcut to verify whether your answer is correct or not, right? So if you can carefully analyze, you can see for what we are doing here is we are finding the all factors for 18, right? We are finding the all factors. That means we have to multiply two numbers. We have to get 18 as an answer. That means these are all the factors of 18, right? So factors of 18. Again, in the last sum, we have find the all the factors of 24, right? So I'll give you a nice formula for number theory. So we are finding the number of factors, right? So number of factors of a number n. So number of factors of 18. Suppose if you need to find the number of factors of 18, you just find the LCM of 18. So it will be 2 times 9, and this is 3 times 3, and 3 times 1. So therefore, our LCM for 18 is 2 into 1 and 3 into 2. Now what you do is, you just add 1 to the power. So the power is 1, so you will just add 1 into, and what is the power for this? 2, and you just add 1, right? So 1 and 2 are already which is in the power, so I'm just adding 1 and then multiplying with the second number. So what you will have? 2 into 3, right? So 6. So there are 6 factors for the number 18. So there are 6 possible combinations. You have to find 6 possible combinations. So again, if you go on to the last example, here the order is 24, right? So what you will do, you just find the LCM for 24 now. So 2 into 12 is 24, 2 into 6 is 12, 2 into 3 is 6, 3 into 1 is 3. So our LCM for 24 is 2 cube into 3 power 1, right? So what you have to do? You just have to write the power and then add 1 to it. Into you have to write the power and add 1 to it. Suppose if there are some more terms, you just write the power of the terms and add 1 to it and multiply, so on. So it will be equal to 4 into 2, right? It's equal to 8. So there are 8 possible factors for 24. So that's why we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's why we have 8 possible factors, right? Yeah. So these are the 9 possible, this is the easy shortcuts to find the number of factors. So after finding number of factors, you just find all 8. So you don't miss some combinations, right? So if you know that there are 8 possible combinations, then you can find all 8. Suppose if you do exam, suppose you intention to write only 6, then you may think only there are only 6 possible combinations. But if you do this calculation, then you know that there are 8 factors. So you can find out all the 8 factors. So we'll move on to the fourth problem now. So consider a 2x2 matrix. Construct a 2x2 matrix whose elements are given by. Yeah, these are very easy problems, right? So we need to construct a 2x2 matrix A, and it has to be 2x2 matrix. That means two rows, two columns, right? A21, A22. We need to construct a 2x2 matrix, and the first problem is Aij has to be equal to I plus j whole square divided by 2. So what will be our A11? So I is 1, j is 1 whole square by 2. So 2 square is 4, right? So this is 4 by 2, which is equal to 2. And what is our A12? A12 is 1 plus 2 whole square by 2. So 3 square is 9, so 9 by 2. And what will be our A21? I is 2, j is 1. So this will be 2 plus 1 whole square divided by 2. So this is again 3. So 3 square is 9. So again it is 9 by 2. What will be our A22? A22 will be equal to 2 plus 2 whole square divided by 2. So 2 plus 2 is 4, right? 4 square is 16 by 2, which is equal to 18. So our matrix A is, our A11 is 2, and our A12 is 9 by 2, and our A21 is 9 by 2 again, and A22 is 8. This is our 2x2 matrix. So we will move on to the second problem now. So second problem is Aij has to be equal to I by j, right? So this element has to satisfy this condition. So again we need to construct a 2x2 matrix A11, A12, A21, A22. So what will be our A11? I is 1, j is 1. So that means 1 by 1, which is equal to 1. What will be our A12? I is 1, j is 2. What will be our A21? 2 by 1, right? And what will be our A22? Which is equal to 2 by 2, which is equal to 1. So therefore, our matrix A will be 1, 1 by 2, 2, 1. So this is our required matrix, right? So you can see that Ij will be transformed to I by j. So I is 1, j is 1. So 1 by 1. Here I is 1, j is 2. So I by j. So this is I by j. So 1 by 2. Right? Yeah. So we'll move on to the third problem now. The third problem is the elements to satisfy this condition. That is Aij is equal to I plus 2j whole square by 2. So third is Aij is equal to I plus 2j whole square by 2. Right? So check the question now. So I plus 2j whole square by 2. Yeah. So we need to construct a 2x2 matrix, right? So therefore our A will be A11, A12, A21, A22. We need to construct this matrix. So what will be our A11? A11, I is 1, j is 1. So 1 plus 2 into 1 square by 2. So this will be equal to 1 plus 3, right? 1 plus 2 is 3. So 3 square is 9. And what will be our A12? So it will be 1 plus 2 into 2 whole square divided by 2. So this will be equal to 1 plus 4 square by 2. So 1 plus 4 is 5. 5 square is 25 by 2. And what will be our A21? So again 2 plus 2 into 1 whole square divided by 2. So that means this is 2 plus 2 is 4. So 4 square is 16 by 2, which is equal to 8. And what will be our A22? A22 will be 2 plus 2 into 2 whole square divided by 2. So our 2 plus, this is 4, right? So 2 plus 4 whole square divided by 2. So this is 36. 6 square is 36. So 36 by 2, which is equal to 18. So our matrix A will be 9 by 2, 25 by 2, 8 and 18. This is our required matrix. So we move on to the next problem now. So we have solved the first problem, and these are very elementary problems. So the second problem you have solved, right? Yeah. And third problem you have finished. Fourth problem you have finished. And now we are in fifth problem. So construct a 3x4 matrix whose elements are given by. So again, it is a modulus symbol, right? So in the last video, I explained what is my modulus. We need to construct a 3x4 matrix. So let us take a matrix A to B. 3x4 means what? It has to contain 3 rows and 4 columns. So 3 rows and 4 columns. So A11, A12, A13 and A14, right? Because it has to contain what? 4 columns. So A14 and again A21, A22, A23 and A24 and A31, A32, A33 and A34. So we need to construct this matrix, and the first condition is, the first sum is Aij has to be equal to 1/2 − 3i + j, and the second sum is Aij is equal to 2i − j. So I will solve the first sum, you do second problem in your own, right? So the first is Aij is equal to 1/2 − 3i + j, right? So A, what will be our A11? 1/2 · i = 1, j = 1. So this will be equal to 1/2 − 3 + 1. So 1/2 − −2, −2 = 2, right? It is equal to 1. So what will be our A12? Our i = 1, j = 2. So −3 × 1 + 2. So this will be equal to 1/2 − 3 + 2. So 1/2 − −1. So which will be equal to 1/2. So what will be our A13? 1/2 − −3 × 1 + j. Right? So this will be equal to 1/2 − −3 + 3. So 1/2, this is √0, which is nothing but 0/2, which is equal to 0, right? So what will be our A14? A14 is equal to 1/2 and −3 × 1 + j, or j is 4. So 1/2 − 3 + 4, which is equal to √1/2, which is equal to 1/2. And what will be our A21? It is 1/2 − 3 × 2 + j, right? Our I is 2 and j is 1. So I is 2, j is 1. It is equal to 1/2 − 6 + 1. So it will be √−5/2, which is equal to 5/2. So similarly, you can construct a matrix like, so far you have constructed the first row. So 1, 1/2, 0, 1/2, and here it is 5/2. So in similar way, you can fill up these entries, right? For example, if you want to find this entries, it is equal to A34, right? So it will be equal to what? 1/2 − 3 × 3 + 4, right? Our I is 3, j is 4. So it will be 1/2 − −9 + 4. And this will be equal to √−5, and this will be equal to 5/2. So therefore, this entry will be 5/2. So similarly, you can fill up these entries. And the second problem is, you can do this, right? So Aij has to be equal to 2i − j. For example, this entry will be what? 2 × 1 − 1, which will be 1. This entry will be 2 × 1 − 2. This entry will be 0. Here I is 1, j is 3. So this entry will be 2 × 1 − 3, which will be equal to −1. So in similar way, you can finish these two matrix, right? So these are very elementary problems. So we'll move on to the next problem, that is a sixth problem. So find the value of x, y, z from the following equations. So we need to find the value of x, y, z, and it is given that the matrix are equal. Right, it is given that the matrix are equal, right? Because you can see there is a equality symbol between this sign here. So we know when two matrix will be equal, right? The matrix will be equal if the entries are same, the corresponding entries are same. So that means 4 has to be equal to y. So therefore, the first problem, y is equal to what? 4. And x has to be equal to 1, right? X has to be equal to 1. And z has to be equal to 3. So that's it. Z has to be equal to 3. So therefore, our answer will be x is equal to 1, y is equal to 4, and z is equal to 3, right? Yeah. So we move on to second problem now. So again, you can see x plus y has to be equal to 6, right? Because it's an equal matrix. So x plus y has to be equal to 6, and 5 plus z has to be equal to 5, right? So 5 plus z has to be equal to 5, and xy has to be equal to 8. XY has to be equal to 8. So I'll take this equation as 1, and I'll take this equation as 2, I'll take this equation as 3, right? So you can see from here, 5 plus z is equal to 5. So that means z is equal to 5 minus 5, right? So this means z is equal to 0. Z is equal to 0, right? Z is equal to 0. Now we need to find only x and y now. So from 1 and 3 we can solve, right? So from 1 and 3, so from 1 and 3 we have x plus y is equal to 6 and xy is equal to 8. Now we can solve these two equations to find the value of x and y. So this you can usually do this, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to replace y is equal to 6 minus x. So I'm going to substitute y is equal to 6 minus x in this equation. So this will be equal to x into 6 minus x is equal to 8, right? So therefore, this will be equal to 6x minus x square is equal to 8, right? So if I bring these terms to that side, I'll have x square minus 6x plus 8 is equal to 0. Now this is a quadratic equation, right? So we need to find the value of x. So there will be 2x because we are finding the roots for x square minus 6x plus 8 is equal to 0. So there will be 2 roots for this quadratic equation. So you can solve this by factorization method, right? So our sum will be equal to minus 6 and the product will be equal to 8, right? Sum is the middle term and product is the coefficient of x square into the constant term. So 1 into 8 is minus 6. So you need to multiply two number, you have to get minus 6. If I add this, you have to get minus 6, and if you multiply this, you have to get 8. So I can do this like minus 2 minus 4, right? So minus 2 minus 4 is minus 6, and minus 2 into minus 4 is plus 8. So our roots will be what? X square minus 2x minus 4x plus 8 is equal to 0. So I can take x common here. So x minus 2, I can take minus 4 common here, again x minus 2 is equal to 0. So therefore, x minus 2 into x minus 4 is equal to 0. So this means our x is equal to 2 and 4. So there are two values for x, that is x can be equal to 2 or x can be equal to 4. So I'm going to find the value of y. So when x is equal to 2, what is our y value? Y is 6 minus x, so I make this as star. So from star y is equal to 6 minus x, so 6 minus 2, it will be equal to 4. So when x is equal to 2, y will be equal to 4, right? And what will happen when x is equal to 4? When x is equal to 4, again from star y is equal to 6 minus x, so this will be 6 minus 4, it is equal to 2. So therefore y is equal to 2. You can see z, we have only one value for z, but we have two values for x and y. So therefore, the solution is, when x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4, z is always equal to 0, right? Again, when x is equal to 4, y is equal to 2, z is always equal to 0. So these are the x, y, z we need to find. So you can substitute here to check whether the answer is correct or not. So what we have found is, there are two possible solutions for x, y, z. The first solution is x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4, z is equal to 0. And the second solution is x is equal to 4, y is equal to 2, and z is equal to 0. You can substitute here, you can see x plus y. So x plus y will be 2 plus 4. It is equal to 6, right? So it satisfies. And again, x into y is equal to 8. So therefore, 2 into 4 is equal to 8. So therefore, this is one of the solution. And another solution is, x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 2. So there are two possible solutions for x, y, z. So always you take it as a pair, right? So this is one pair and this is another pair. So there are two pairs of x, y, z such that when you substitute x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4, z is equal to 0, then this two matrix will be equal. And another possible solution is x is equal to 4, y is equal to 2, z is equal to 0, so that you will get the matrix to be equal, right? So that's it. So this is our second problem. Solutions are, this is a solution for second problem, right? Yes. So we'll solve the third problem now. So x plus y plus z is equal to x plus y plus z. So I'll just change the pen color so that you will have difference between. So the third subdivision is this x plus y plus z. So x plus y plus z and x plus z y plus z x plus z and y plus z has to be equal to 957, right? 957. So it has to be equal to 9, 5, and 7. So again, these two matrices has to be equal. So therefore, our x plus y plus z has to be equal to 9 and x plus z has to be equal to 5 because the entries has to be same, right? And again, y plus z has to be equal to 7. So that means this first element has to be equal, this element has to be equal, and this element has to be equal. So we need to find the value of x, y, and z, right? Yeah. So how can we do this? So we just need to solve the equation. So I'll take this as equation 1. I take this as 2, I take this as equation number 3, right? Now what we will do? We can solve this in many ways, right? So first what I'll do is, so since we have here x plus y plus z is equal to 9, what I'll do is, first I'll transform x in terms of z and y in terms of z, right? So I'm going to transform x in terms of z and y in terms of z. So from 2 we have x is equal to 5 minus z, right? So I'm just giving x here and bringing z to this side. So again here I'm going to transform y in terms of z. So it will be equal to what? 7 minus z, right? So you can see our x and y are equation of z. I'm going to substitute these two in equation number 1. So equation 1 becomes, then equation 1 becomes, it is x plus y plus z is equal to 9, right? So I'm going to replace x to be equal to 5 minus z and y to be equal to 7 minus z and giving z as it is, right? So I'm just finding the value of z. So it will be equal to 5 minus z plus 7 minus z plus z is equal to 9. So you can see this z and this z will get cancelled. So 5 plus 7 is 12 and 12 minus z is equal to 9. So this means if I take z to this side and 9 to this side, so I'll have 12 minus 9 is equal to z. So that means z has to be equal to 3. So we have found the value for z, right? So since we have found the value for z, we can find the others two very easily. So from 2 we have what? X is equal to 5 minus z, right? X is equal to 5 minus z. So our x, since substitute z is equal to 3, right? So from 2 this will be equal to 5 minus 3, it will be equal to 2. So therefore x is equal to 2. And again substitute z is equal to 3 from 3. So from 3 we have y is equal to 7 minus z. So therefore it is equal to 7 minus 3, which is equal to 4. So therefore y is equal to 4, right? So therefore the solution is x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4, z is equal to 3. This is the required x, y, z. So you can verify this. So exam you just verified, right? You just have to add 3 numbers. So it will be equal to 2 plus 4 plus 3. 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 plus 3 is 9. So you have 9 here. X plus z, so x plus z, 2 plus 3 is 5, so again you have 5 here. Y plus z, so 4 plus 3 is 7, so we have 7 here. So therefore our solution is correct, right? So move on to the 7th problem now. So again find the value of a, b, c, d from the equation. Again it is given that the matrix are equal, so therefore our corresponding entries has to be equal, right? So a minus b has to be equal to minus 1, and 2a plus c has to be equal to 5, and 2a minus b has to be equal to 0, and 3c plus d has to be equal to 13. Now we need to solve these four equations to find the value of a, b, c, d, right? So this is 2, this is third equation, and I mark this as fourth equation, right? Yeah. So you can see this equation and this equation is independent, this is only of a and b, right? So I can solve these two equations to find the value for a and b, and after finding a and b, we will substitute a here so that we will get c, and substitute c here so that we will get d, right? So first we will solve 1 and 2. So solving equation 1 and 3, right? Solving 1 and 3. So our first equation is what? A minus b is equal to minus 1. And our third equation is 2a minus b is equal to 0, right? So I can just change the sign so that it will be equal to, I'm just multiplying this whole by minus. So this will be minus, this will be plus, and this will be, it will not have effect because of 0 here. So if I add that, you will have a minus 2a is equal to minus 1. So that means minus a is equal to minus 1. So this means a is equal to 1. Right? So we have found the value of a. So if we substitute the value of a in 1 or 3, you can do this in anywhere. So 1 becomes, so from 1, a minus b is equal to minus 1. So if we substitute a is equal to 1, so put a is equal to 1. So we'll have 1 minus b is equal to minus 1. So if I bring b to this side and 1 to this side, so I'll have 1 plus 1 is equal to b. So that means b is equal to 2. So far what we have done is, we have solved the first and third equation to find the value of a and b. Now from 2 I can find c value, right? So from 2 we have 2a plus c is equal to 5. So I'm going to substitute, put a is equal to 1. So I'll have 2 into 1 plus c is equal to 5. So this means c is equal to 5 minus 2. This is equal to c 3. So therefore c is equal to 3. So we have found a, b, c. Now I can substitute c value in equation 4 to find the value of d, right? So these are just a child's play. You just have to solve the equations. So from 4, we have 4c plus d, right? So 3c plus d is equal to 13. So you substitute, put c is equal to 3. So we'll have 3 into 3 plus d is equal to 13. So d is equal to 13. So 3 into 3 is 9. So if you bring that to that side, I'll have 9. So which is equal to 4. So therefore, d is equal to 4. So therefore, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, c is equal to 3, and d is equal to 4. The solution is, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, c is equal to 3, and d is equal to 4. So you can verify here. So you just find a minus b. So 1 minus 2 minus 1 satisfies. 2a plus c. So just multiply 2a. It will be 2. 2 plus 3 is 5. So therefore it satisfies. 2a minus b. So 2 into a is 1. 2 into 1. 2 minus 2 is 0. So it is equal to 0. 3c plus d. So 3 into c is 9. 9 plus 4 is 13. So therefore all 4s are satisfied. So therefore solution is correct. So we'll move on to the 8th, 9th problem. The 8th, 9th problems are just multiple choice questions. Now we know when the matrix will be square matrix, right? When the matrix will be square matrix, if the number of rows, I'll just zoom this. So when the matrix will be square matrix, you know, a matrix will be square matrix if number of rows is equal to number of columns, right? So number of rows has to be equal to number of columns, right? That is what I explained in the second video. That means m is the number of rows, n is the number of columns. So therefore m has to be equal to n, right? Yeah. So we'll move on to the 10th problem, and then we'll come back to the 9th problem. The number of all possible matrices of order 3 cross 3 with each entry 0 or 1. So we need to find all possible matrix of order 3 cross 3 with entries 0 or 1, right? That is, we need to find all possible 3 cross 3 matrix. The entries can be 0 or 1. For example, it can be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, right? Or it can be 1, 0, 0, we can have infinite number of possible combinations, right? Finite number of possible combinations, right? So now you can see, so there are 9 elements here, right? So here the number of elements is equal to 9, and this element can be what? Either 0 or 1, right? So every element can be either 0 or 1. Each entry is 0 or 1. This is 0 and 1. This is 0 or 1. So how many possible combinations we can have? If each entry is 0 or 1, then total number of permutation is what? Total number of permutation is 2, right? So we have only 2 permutation, that is either 2 or 9. So therefore, permutation of 9 elements. So we need to permutate 9 elements, right? So permutation of 9 elements is equal to 2 power 9, right? That's it. So what is 2 power 9? So 2 power 9 is 512. Right, so that means there are 512 matrix we can form 512 matrix such that each entry is 0 or 1, right? So since you have only 2 permutation, you just raise number of elements to that power, you will get the required answer. And which of the given values of x, y, the following matrices are equal, right? So we need to find the value of x and y such that they are equal. So from this you can see 3x plus 7 has to be equal to 0, right? 3x plus 7 has to be equal to 0. And from this, y has to be equal to y minus 2, right? Y has to be equal to 5, y minus 2. So this means from here 3x is equal to minus 7, so x is equal to minus 7 by 3, right? If you solve this here 2 minus 3x is equal to 4, so that means 3x is equal to 2 minus 4, 3x is equal to minus 2, x is equal to minus 3 by 2. So you can see our x is not unique, right? So this is a linear. Here we have to be very careful. Here we have quadratic equation, right? Then so that's why we have two roots. But here it is a linear equation, right? So what? We cannot have different x. So therefore, not possible to find, right? So if we substitute x is equal to minus 7 by 3 here, this will be equal. But if we substitute x is equal to minus 7 by 3 here, this will not be equal. Again, if you substitute x is equal to minus 3 by 2, this will be equal. But if you substitute x is equal to minus 3 by 2 here, it will not be equal. So therefore, this matrix can never be a equal matrices, right? Yeah. So that's it. So I think we have finished exercise 3.1, right? So we have solved all 10 problems in exercise 3.1. So this is exercise 3.1, and in the next video what I will do is I will give an introduction to operation on matrices. So this is very important, and please go through the part 1 because I have given an introduction, right? So please go through the introduction video, then it will be easy for you to follow the operation on matrices. So that's it. We'll see in the next video. Goodbye. Thank you. And please subscribe to the channel, and please share with your friends. Thank you.